live, live in peace, live in peace again.
So to honor him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, when we come.
Every child must be
my drum for him, ba-rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. I play my best for him,
ba-rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. Live in peace again.
Then he smiled at me, ba-rum-pa-pum-pum, me and my drum.
He did not wait until the world was ready, till men and nations were at peace. He came when the heavens were unsteady and prisoners cried out for release. He did not wait for the perfect time. He came when the need was deep and great. He dined with sinners in all their grime, turned water into wine. He did not wait till hearts were pure. In joy, he came to a tarnished world of sin and doubt, to a world like ours of anguish, shame. He came, and his light would not go out. He came to a world which did not mesh, to heal its tangles, shield its scorn. In the mystery of the Word made flesh, the Maker of the stars was born. We cannot wait till the world is sane, to raise our songs with joyful voice, for to share our grief, to touch our pain. He came with love. Rejoice, rejoice.
The Savior. Prepared ourselves for communion. As our deacons and elders come forward, would you sing the third verse again, please?
As we prepare our hearts for communion, I want you to think about this. Jesus as the Christ child, or Jesus as the adult, was the only person from history who was ever born for the express purpose of dying. He came to die for our sins so that we might have everlasting life. The only one that you will ever find in history who came for that reason. And just this morning, as I was getting ready, I heard on one of the shows that I listened to on Sunday morning about Christmas communion and communion during Christmas time. And that we should think of it this way. When we partake of the bread and the cup, we are recognizing Christmas and Easter. Christmas because the bread represents the Christ child, the body, God in human form, who came to save our sins, to forgive our sins. So the bread represents what we think of as the birth of the Christ child for Christmas. And the cup represents the blood Jesus shed on the cross for our sins. So we are doing Christmas and we are doing Easter. Kind of a novel thought, I thought. At any rate, this morning, please close your eyes, give thanks. In your hearts, see the innocent Christ child lying in a feeding trough, wrapped in probably rags. He is our Savior.